This is a second stimulus check update. In this video, I'll go over the latest updates, as well as an approximate date of when you could expect a second stimulus check. I'll give info on how to get financial aid for housing, utilities, food. I'm also giving more cash to subscribers, so stay tuned to that later on in the video for more details. Let's get right into it. So here is the paper check schedule for the first stimulus check. So if you make less than $70,000, your paper check will be mailed out June 5th, and it could take up to 14 days delivery time. Unfortunately, I've been getting a lot of comments still from people who on SSI, SSDI, veterans haven't yet received the first stimulus check. There's three things you could do. Check the Get My Payment tool, or what I like to call the Waste My Time tool, because it's been giving people more headaches than help, but you could try your luck there. Second, if you call the IRS number, so there's two IRS numbers you could call, test your luck to see if you could get anyone on the phone, 800-919-9835, or this one, 800-829-1040. And if you did not receive your first stimulus check, but you got this letter from the IRS, then hold on to this letter, and then you could provide it as proof later on saying that you did not receive your stimulus check. Next, let's talk about the current unemployment status. So according to CBS News, 3 million Americans applied for unemployment last week, which brings it to over 42 million workers who are affected by the coronavirus. And according to the Federal Reserve, 14 million of those jobs might not come back. And if you check out this graph here, this is a good one, still in CBS News. So this is regular unemployment, and then this is pandemic unemployment assistance. You can see the numbers there, big difference. And then this is the news release by the Department of Labor. If you want, you could pause the screen of the number of changes that have been going on week by week. This is only until May 23rd. The unemployment claim numbers are a week behind, so we'll find out last week's number in a few days from now. Also, there are still a lot of delays in terms of people getting their unemployment checks. So if you just Google your state and unemployment delays, then you could find out more information, it goes state by state, of when you could expect to get your unemployment check. Now, in regards to second stimulus check updates, this is according to CNBC, GOP doesn't want more stimulus checks. So the GOP is taking the stance, Republicans are taking the stance, that they want to wait and see what happens. With states starting to open up more, businesses opening up more, they want to see how the economy is going to be affected by that. But what they're not taking into account are all the jobs that are lost, unemployment checks not being paid, grocery prices going up, as well as rent, which is due now. So today is June 2nd, it was due yesterday, up until the 5th. There are a lot of people who can't even make that payment or don't know how to make that payment. I'll give more information later on in the video on in terms of eviction delays. According to Mitch McConnell, his quote on the second stimulus check, he would want it to be narrowly crafted and designed to help us where we are in a month from now, not where we were 3 months ago. Now, I think it's important to help those in need with the second stimulus check, but there are so many people who are suffering right now and are waiting for aid that is not coming to them. If you were curious how the American government is treating its own people in regards to stimulus checks and financial aid compared to other countries, if we check out this, I went more in detail on this on my video May 26th, but here's nine other countries between North America, Asia, Australia, and some European countries. You could pause the screen if you want, but this is how other countries are helping their people. So when it comes to getting a second stimulus check, some Democrats, who are the ones who proposed the HEROES Act, which would be the second stimulus check of $1,200, a few of them are saying that it may not be a good idea, although there are Republicans who do think direct payments are a good idea as well. The main issue of what is slowing down the process is this. So this is the HEROES Act. You could pause the screen if you want. There's a lot of non-pandemic spending here, which is what Republicans have said they have an issue with. The Republicans said they do not have an issue with direct payments to Americans. It's more these numbers right here. So now let's talk about an estimated date of when you could expect a second stimulus check if we get one. So Mitch McConnell said that he wanted to wait about a month. Now, if we look at the schedule here, this is according to the Senate. They just got back from vacation or recess or state work period, whatever you want to call it. Yesterday was the first day back. Then on July 3rd, which is a Friday, to July 17th, which is a Friday, but they get back on that Monday, that is 17 days that they will be out of office as well. So if they could pass the second stimulus check, pass a bill for that before this date, last time it took 2 weeks from March 27th until April 15th before people got their first stimulus checks. So according to this, if they make their decision before July 3rd, before they go on a 17-day break, then we could expect it mid-July. And if they really wanted to help the American people, they could cut a lot of this spending here that's in the bill and give direct payments to Americans. They should just create a separate bill on its own where it just gives Americans direct payments, and then all this other stuff like the US Postal Service, tribal relief for small businesses, they could decide that at a later point. What's needed now is aid to Americans to pay their rent, utilities, food. But the main reason why the Senate thinks it's okay to wait and not give Americans help right away is because they're living the good life. They get a vacation almost every week. They're making $174,000 a year. If we look at this, Nancy Pelosi has a net worth of $120 million. So this is some information here. This is according to MoneyInc.com. And then Mitch McConnell has a net worth of $30 million. So if they're worth millions of dollars, the Senate has a salary of $174,000. What do they care about the American people? Life is good. You know, they're able to eat, they're able to pay off their cars, they have probably low mortgage payments compared to the rest of Americans. Life is good to them. What they don't realize are the millions of Americans on the brink of homelessness and not able to feed their families. This isn't about getting enough money to get the latest iPhone or Jordans. This is about paying their rent or mortgage and providing food for their family to survive during this crisis. Before moving on, I wanted to talk about how I'm giving more cash to my subscribers and how it could potentially be you and how you could qualify. So last week I gave cash to subscribers as well as donated to charities on their behalf. So I donated to St. Jude's Hospital, Shriners Children's Hospital, Suicide Prevention Hotline. I got a lot of great feedback from it, and I'm going to do this again and on a recurring basis. So I want to help out the Wise Flies community as well as help out other communities and have a greater reach. So to be one of five random winners to receive cash and then I'll donate to a charity of your choice, you have to do three things. First, subscribe to both my channels. There'll be more information on this down in the description below. Second is to join my email list. This way I can personally notify you if you won or not. It was a little hard to track people down before with social media. Not everybody has it. And then third is to write what you are thankful for. So I know times are hard right now, but we really need to count our blessings. So if you comment down below what you are thankful for and you have to use the word thankful, then I'll pick someone at random from one of those comments. Next, I want to talk about how to get financial assistance. I've been getting so many comments of people who can't afford to pay for medicine, food, rent, mortgage. So if we look here, 211.org is a great resource. So you just type in what your zip code is, or county, or city, and it'll provide you all of the local assistance in terms of electric bill, water bill, gas. I'll get over rent and food in a minute. But if you are in this situation where you feel like you don't have enough money to cover the bills, try to call your utility company, credit card company, every company, and see if they will allow for a delay in payments. Also, if you are facing eviction, there is eviction protection under the CARES Act. Not many people know about this. So under the CARES Act, you have 120 days of eviction relief for tenants in federally backed housing. So you have until July 25th to get the notice of eviction. And then from that point, 30 days to leave the property. So that's 120 days from March 27th. During the 120-day eviction moratorium, your landlord may not charge you late fees, penalties, or other charges for paying your rent late. There's also CARES Act tenant-based rental assistance. So this gave $17.4 billion to Housing and Urban Development, also known as HUD. And this is giving assistance for rent, housing vouchers, public housing, housing for elderly. So if you want more information, you could call HUD, Housing and Urban Development. It's 202-708-112 if you want to see how you could get assistance or if you qualify. Next, in terms of food, a lot of schools are still providing meals, one meal a day to kids throughout the summer, but just check your local school to see if they're still doing that or not. Also, there's immediate food aid. So if you call this number here, 1-866-348-6479, or if you want a Spanish one, this is 1-877-842-6273 to get assistance in seeing how you could get food. There's a lot of organizations right now that are providing food to the community. And as I mentioned before, 211.org is a great resource to let you know where there is food. So if we just click food, I did it for South Carolina since that's where I'm at. Food pantries, soup kitchens, food for babies. There's a lot of great resources to figure out how to feed yourself as well as family. Let me know in the comments if you want more information on financial aid assistance like food, utilities, rent, how else to get money to help during these hard times. Let me know in the comments below if this was helpful and if you want more of this. And if you want to watch more second stimulus check updates, you could click this playlist over here or this video over here. Take care, be safe. Thank you for watching.